Hey everybody, if you want to make lights in your Blender scene more interesting, IES lighting files are a great and free way to do it. Unfortunately, they only work in Cycles right now and do not work in Eevee as of the date of this video. IES stands for Illuminating Engineering Society. Manufacturers of real-world lights like those in your house and street lamps or spotlights create IES light files to virtually demonstrate how light from their lamps are distributed. These files are available for free, for personal and commercial use, and are really easy to use in Blender. The website IESlibrary.com is a database of about 200,000 of these light files organized and rendered out with preview images. All files are free to download, but I will point out that the creator of the site does take donations if you're feeling generous. According to IESlibrary.com, the IES files are not licensed. They're made publicly available by manufacturers, so you are free to use them in all of your projects. Just go to the website, that's IESlibrary.com, and click Browse. You can sort by a list of tags such as ceiling lights, outdoor, floodlights, etc. Also, if you have a certain light in the real world that you are trying to mimic, you can search by manufacturer and see if you can find it in the library. Or just explore until you find something you like. The site seems to always be improving as they just recently added a feature to favorite lights so you can come back and find them later. That does, however, require a login, which you do not need to download and use the free IES files. Find a light that you want to use in your scene. Click on the preview images and then click Download IES. A very small file will download to your computer. By the way, giving this video a like if you've made it this far is always appreciated. In Blender, using Cycles, I will set up a makeshift floor and wall for demonstration purposes. Then add a point lamp. Go to the light property settings and turn on Use Nodes. Then go to the shader editor. You'll have an emission shader plugged into a light output node. Press Shift-A to add a node. Search for an IES texture node or find it under the texture category. You'll see the IES texture node has internal and external. We want to import a file, so select external and a file folder icon appears. Navigate to your downloaded IES file on your computer. Select the file and press accept. Plug the factor from the IES texture node into the strength of the emission shader. Usually the default strength on the IES node is way too high, so turn that down to like 0.1 and there you go. You've got a light that is much more interesting than just a regular point lamp. You can rotate the light to point it in different directions, and you can still change the emission color on the emission node. Very cool. If you found this short tutorial helpful, please give it a like. Check out my channel for more tutorials and other videos, like the one where I used a render farm for the very first time. Become a subscriber and turn on notifications to see my future videos. One other quick thing is I put some Amazon links in the description below. These are for products that I recommend for digital artists. As an Amazon associate, I earn a small commission on qualifying sales, and it really helps my site. My website is brandonsdrawings.com, and I'm of course on Instagram as well. Have fun with IES lighting, and stay creative.